Star sign as we were doing question answers, some extra questions. What were the two questions that were being given yesterday? Yes, our speaker. How has the tree grown? Okay. And second one was, what shall happen to the tree when it is jabbed with a knife? Okay. Write down the question. What happens? What happens when a tree is hacked? What happens when a tree is hacked but not uprooted? But not uprooted. Yes. So what happened when the tree is hacked but not uprooted? Yes, Tanish, can you give the answer? What happens when a tree is hacked but not uprooted? What will happen to the tree? Will you be able to answer? Lavina, yes.
When a tree is hacked but not uprooted, the white bird needs to be present in the tree, which gives its life force.
Now you, 1 minute, please. You go to the last. No, please go. You have started writing. Afterwards, you can. You go to the last, please. Read the question and then. Yes.
The tree feels a lot of pain and then calls being rise from that bird. And many
yes, so ultimately when a hack or chop is given on the back bark of the tree, so what it means that of course the tree is hurt, okay, but what happened that from that hack or chop where it is given or a cut where it is provided on the bark of the tree, new leaves they will sprout and curl out, and soon this tree will grow to its former size, okay, and miniature boss, they also curl around the place where hack or jab is provided, okay. So, this answer, so when a, yes, answer is in second stanza, it means that when a hack or jab is provided on the bark of the tree, then what will happen, new leaves curl out from the place where hack or jab is given or a cut with a knife is given, and moreover the source of the tree, that is the white liquid, that is latex, it oozes out, right? But soon this hack or jab which is provided with a knife, it is soon be recovered, and ultimately miniature boss curl out and on new leaves they also sprout out from this place or where hack or jab is given to the tree, and ultimately it will grow to its former size. Okay. So write down the next question. What does the poet say to do in order to kill a tree? So what is to be done in order to kill a tree? So what is to be done? Very good. It has to be completely uprooted. It, how it will be uprooted? It must be tied with a rope and pulled out with complete force and determination. Okay. And ultimately when it is taken out of the earth cave means where it is, yes, where it is tightly bound with the soil particles for so many years. So ultimately what will happen? The strength of the root, it will be, sorry, the strength of the tree, it will be exposed. Okay, and this exposed strength is actually responsible for the survival of the tree. And when this is exposed, then the white source, which is... yes, it also is exposed, and after following the process of decaying, Okay, and scorching in the heat and as well as in the light, heat and light or heat and light of the sun. The tree shrivels up, okay, and ultimately it shrinks back and the bark is bark also shrinks. And ultimately what will happen? Yes, it ultimately it is killed. Okay, so the tree is ultimately killed. Right? So this is all about this answer. So write down the next question, please. How does the root of the tree look like when it is pulled out of the earth? When it is pulled out of the earth. How does the root of the tree look like when it is pulled out of the earth? So how does the root of the tree look like? So the root of the tree, it seems to enclose the complete strength of the tree. Right? What happened? That it seems to enclose the complete strength of the tree. Right? Okay. It is the main source of providing strength to the tree. It is because of only this root that the tree is surviving, because of its firm anchorage with the earth cave. Okay. Because of its firm anchorage with the earth cave. And for so many years, what happened? That it has made its anchorage with that of the earth. Okay. But when this root, it is subjected to the action of heat and light of the sun, then what will happen? It will shrivel up, it is dried up, and because of decaying and scorching, what will happen? Finally, the tree is killed, right? So now clear this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So, just a moment, please. Now, next question. What does the poet mean by leprous height?
Yes.
Yes, leprous height means, actually leprous height means it is the bark of the tree actually which is compared to that of the skin of a person suffering from leprosy. Okay, suffering from leprosy. Why it is compared? Because it is uneven. Okay, not giving a smooth touch. Okay, and it is uneven, like out of the warts and as well as the mold, water or a liquid. Okay, infectious liquid, it oozes out. Similarly, from the bark of the tree, raisins as well as gums, they are also given out, and ultimately it is giving the same impression that of the person's skin who is suffering from leprosy. Okay, so it is because of this reason the poet has compared it with that of leprous height. Okay. How does the poet personify the tree throughout the poem? How does the poet personify the tree throughout the poem? So how does the poet personify? He has personified it, of course. He has compared it with that of human beings. But how he has compared it? Yes, first of all, the great comparison that he has made, that it grows, okay, by consuming, okay, by consuming air, water and sunlight. It means that the poet is explaining the feeding process of the tree like that of a human being. Okay, of course they are living things, there is no doubt in that, but ultimately the poet wants to tell us that they are consuming air, light, air, water and sunlight, and it grows, okay, like human beings. Then afterwards he has also compared leprous hide, he has also compared to that of the skin of the to the skin of the human being suffering from leprosy. And moreover, when he has specially mentioned about bleeding bark, okay, bleeding bark, what it means, he compares the liquid that is present in the tree in with the blood of the human beings. So throughout the poem he is comparing the tree to that of a human being, that they are of course living creatures like that of human beings. And moreover, when he has used the word kill, okay, when he has used the word kill, it means that it is like it is a phenomena which is subjected to human beings, okay, like that human beings, when they are killed, they never survive further, okay. It means the job is finally done, okay. And he has also given the process that how the tree is to be completely killed, that how it is killed by uprooting it, by tying it, by, you can say, by pulling it with strong force, and ultimately the job is finally done. Okay, so this is how he has personified the tree throughout the poem. What message does the poet want to deliver through this poem? Yes, what message does the poet want to deliver? Yes, ironically, okay, the poet has ironically delivering the message. Because throughout the poem, he is talking about how a tree is killed, okay? How a tree is killed, and ultimately how, you can say, how the process of killing of a tree be carried out. But ultimately, what he wants to deliver is in an ironic way, okay? He wants to tell that actually trees are our lifeline, okay? If we will kill the trees, then there would not be any possibility of life in, there would not be any possibility of survival of life on this earth. And ultimately, okay, like when a jab or hack is given, okay? So ultimately what it will cause, it will only cause a cut on the bark of the tree, but not the killing of the tree. For killing of the tree, what has to be done? It has to be tied up. It has to be, yes, half done is not at all done. Okay. He is delivering this message also. Okay. Yes, this is mainly the theme of the poem, right? Okay. So on this theme, he has written this poem. Okay, so now what is the theme of the poem? So what is the theme of the poem? Yes, there are of course evil desires present, or evil desires which are hidden deep inside our heart. They have made their strong anchorage with our mind as well as heart. And how they have to be taken out? They have to be taken out with strong force out of it. If we need to be determined, we need to be firm in order to take out of them from our mind as well as heart. It means that if we will just make an attack over these evil desires for a short time, or for, you can say, for once or twice, okay, that means that a job is half done. Okay, when a job is half done, it means they will again grow back, okay, and catch hold of a mind and heart. Okay, in evil ways. So what is to be done? We need to make our persistent efforts in order to drive them away from our heart. So while we are trying to drive them away from our heart and mind, what is to be done? Our continuous efforts, they are required. With these continuous efforts, only these can be pulled out. Okay? And because they have made strong anchorage, they have made a firm connection, they have made a strong connection with our body, with our mind and heart. And what is to be done? They have to be completely taken out of that in order to what? In order to make our mind and body free. So this is a thematic representation, okay, which the poet wants to give through the idea of a tree. Okay, so what actually the poet wants to deliver is completely different from that of, you can say, from that of, yes, from that of the message or from what the poet is writing right now. So now the poem is, I hope that it is quite clear to you. Okay, and for that, after that story writing, now you got to know that how a story is written. But when I have checked the notebooks, first thing is that I have seen that many of you have not written the titles. Now take out your notebooks where title is not written, please write down just now. Take out your notebooks. Yes, if title is not written. Yes. I'll see. Okay. It is very short. Otherwise, Vatsal, what you have to do, you have to make different paragraphs. I'm coming to these points. Okay. I'm coming to these points where story is written. Okay. Yes. Yesterday, yes, today it will be sent. Today I will send those. Yes, write down in fair notebook. Because why to write down in fair notebook? Because I feel when you have a practice in notebook, only then you will be able to reproduce in exams. Otherwise, you will be short of answers. Right? Just write down, but don't write down. I'm always saying don't write down too long. Okay? Here you can say expression of language, how it is delivered. It is delivered the way you express the idea. You should know how to compress the matter. You should know how to elaborate it also. So where 2 to 3 marks are there, you have to write down in maximum five to six lines the complete thing you want to deliver. It's not like that you will write down one complete paragraph over it. It means that you don't have a complete hold on your language. Okay? So now I was talking about that many of you have not written the title. So title written. And now open up your story in front of you. What I want to deliver you is that. Where is title? Write down a title then. Okay. So now first of all, see. In case of story writing, I am reading one story in front of me. It is Guess as a Prison. Okay. It was Sunday morning. I woke up in a very dizzy manner, being free after so many days, but the excitement of being free did not last long. As sudden, okay, you give your notebook and let me. Okay, this Archita, this I know that all the students, they are doing this. Okay, that one thing is original and rest all are the copies. Okay, then it's fine. Okay, very good, those who have done. So now, just listen to me. I want to deliver you some of the points which are otherwise lacking in story writing. Okay, because when you will write in exams, when the marks will be deducted, you will be in confusion that I have written all, ma'am has checked all, and finally no mistake is there, still marks are less. Why? Okay, so now concentrate upon those points. Like first of all, few stories I have checked in the notebooks where you can say the outline given. You are not starting the story from the outline given. Okay, so what you have to do after writing the title, what you have to do, you have to start the story exactly with what the outline is given. Okay, so try to write down that outline with blue pen and underline it so that the examiner will come to know that it is already given. And ultimately from where the point okay, the examiner has left the story. From there, your ideas, it will start. Okay, so now in this story also that is in front of me, see this complete story, it is written in one paragraph. I have told you different ways to write down. Okay, so I told you first paragraph, how it is to be made. The first paragraph is to be made in which you will set the plot, introduce the characters. Okay, so let me tell you and let me read and I will tell you the mistakes here. No need. No, it's not like main characters you have introduced. Okay, it is like you are saying like, ma'am, all characters to be defined. No, like you are introducing them. So you will not write down that there was in a house lived a man. He has four sons. The first son was long and tall. Okay, and he was quite lazy. Okay, the youngest son was very active. Okay, always playing in the ground and bagging number of prizes. No, not in this manner. It's not like a factual description. It will turn out into a factual description. Thing is that you should introduce the characters as you are proceeding. Sometimes when you are reading, you can say good stories, good novels and whatever. Suppose we have read this, Santosh Yadav, suppose we have read, although it is a description about her. But ultimately here in the starting, main characters are explained. Okay. Right, and ultimately their role has also been cleared in the very first paragraph. Okay, so how her parents were, okay, what is the family background, okay, we have also come to know about her, you can say the type of atmosphere, conservative atmosphere prevalent in the family. So now what is this? It means that we have come to know there and then that what kind of family it was. See first paragraph, how much it is important, right? So let me read it here. So many days, but the excitement of being free did not last long, as suddenly a phone call came from my mother that guests are coming and I have to welcome them. Okay, my all plan got it is ruined, as I thought to only hang out with my friends today. Then I saw that there, and yes, one more thing, there is always a confusion between the spelling. This is one of the common mistake in exams, that the students, they are always writing or they are confusing the spellings of there and there. So what is the difference between this? Very simple question. So there, what is this? This is reference to that of place, and this is reference to that of possession. Okay, when we show, for example, this is their, these are their notebooks. Okay, here which there I will use? IR1. Okay, there are. Okay, there are 40 students in the class. It means here I'm talking about this. Then this one is to be used. Okay, this mistake is there. So now, like, in this story, it is appropriately explained about the excitement of being free, but then what happened? But see how... you can say early you have come to the problem. Okay, it is, but my all plan has been ruined. It has been started in the very first paragraph. Okay, so make first paragraph like that. How you have to make first paragraph? Like introduce the characters, develop the scene so that the reader will come to know that what actual the story is about. Okay, so from here I have come to know, or the reader has come to know, yes, of course, the story is about your family. Now, give it to me. Second question was, how Santosh Yadav was an example for all. Give it to me, please. How Santosh Yadav was an example for all. Yes. So now, then afterwards, make another paragraph here. See, one complete paragraph, no paragraphs are made. Okay, so make different paragraphs. In second paragraph, elaborate the story further. Okay, you will elaborate, may add some more incidents. And in that incidents, you will also introduce short dialogues. Okay, the introduction of dialogues is very important for story writing. Okay, this was almost absent in many of the notebooks that I have checked. And then afterwards, come to the third or in the middle of the story, then introduce the problem. Okay, then introduce the problem, what the main character is suffering from. Now, it is cause and effect relationship. What kind of cause and effect relationship? Suppose that one is causing the problem and the other, you can say characters which are in opposition, they are increasing the problem. So make a problem in this manner. Okay, then ultimately then come to solution, but not, I said solution in an immediate manner. Create some suspense. Okay, create some suspense in order to develop the story. Okay, and finally give the solution in an unexpected manner. So then afterwards I set the timings. He again ruined them by tearing them or kept throwing the things. My half of the tiredness was only because of my dog. Then I started making lunch for them. I am the worst cook in my house. In kitchen also I made trouble as I didn't know which was salt or which was sugar. I put salt in tea and sugar in food. When I tasted, its taste was intolerable. Then I made the entire food again. So whatever here there is, you can say there is lack of problem. Okay, because the more the person or the writer is concentrating upon himself. Okay, so try to introduce problem, then give the solution in an unexpected manner. So my purpose of giving a story writing to you is that you should practice on your own. Okay, so second one we will discuss afterwards. Okay, so now any doubt in the poem Killing a Tree? I hope that it is fine. Now you will be ready for tests. Okay, so that's all for today.